Hello Team Bajus, here is my brief introduction. My name is Rishabh Verma and I am currently residing in Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. I have done my high school and intermediate science background from CBSE Board and I have done my graduation in electrical engineering. Today we are going to learn about number system. In this lecture we will talk about three things. First, what are numbers? Second, why we use number? And third, classification of number. So move to the first one. What are numbers? So numbers are nothing but symbols or words that represent a quantity. So numbers are nothing but symbols or words that represent a quantity. So number is a quantifiable representation of something. Now move to the next. Why we use numbers? So numbers are very useful to us because by using numbers we do calculations. We do calculations and arrive at some result. And by using these results, we make decisions. So numbers are useful to us because by using numbers, we do calculations and arrive at some results. And by using these results, we make decisions. Now, come to the third topic, that is classification of number or types of numbers. Numbers are broadly classified into two types, that is imaginary number and real number. A real number is any number which we can think of or which exists in the real world. A real number is any number about which we can think of and which exists in real world. Real number is further divided into rational number, irrational number. In mathematics, a rational number is defined as any number which can be written in the form P by Q, where Q cannot be equal to 0. But by looking at the word, that is rational itself, we can think that rational is related to something which is logical or reasonable. So rational number is a number about which we can make certain statements, by applying logic or reasons. Whereas in mathematics, an irrational number is a number which cannot be written in the form P by Q. So, in mathematics, a rational number is a number or any number which can be written in the form P by Q, or irrational is a number which cannot be written in the form P by Q. Now, rational number is further divided into fractions and integers. So, fraction is nothing but when we represent part of something whole, like if I write 2 by 3, it means 2 part of 3 whole. Like there are 3 toffees, if I select 2 toffees, then we can represent the selected toffees as 2 by 3, means 2 part of the total 3 toffees we have selected. And integers are further classified as positive integer, negative integer and zero integer. So zero integer, positive integer and negative integer. Now, zero integer and positive integer together form whole number. And positive integer alone form or gives us natural number. Okay? So, one can ask where the decimal form? Decimal is nothing but the representation of fraction. Decimal is a kind of representation of fraction. And one can ask, integer is written like this, minus 2, 1, 3, here, is it in the form P by Q? One can ask, sir, is it in the form P by Q? Yes, it is in the form of P by Q. It is in the form of P by Q, where Q is equal to 1. In all the integers, the value of Q is always 1. Okay? Now, the natural number is further divided into
odd number, even number, composite number, prime number, co-prime number, etc. Okay, so odd number is any number which cannot be divided by, which shall not be divided by 2. Even number which can be divided by 2. Which cannot be divided by 2, which can be divided by 2. Composite number has more than 2 factors. Prime numbers only has 2 factors. The number itself and 1. This only is important here. It has, the prime number is a number which only has 2 factors. Co-prime numbers are those pair of numbers which do not have any factor common in them. One thing should be noted here, 2 is the only even prime number. 2 is the only even prime number. Rest all numbers are odd in the prime categories. So this is all about our class today. Thank you.